Consulate General of the Republic of Indonesia in Dubai celebrated their 76th Independence Day.
The first important thing that the president always deliver the message, or the key message from the president, is the safety first. The safety of tourists, the safety of the local population, of the industry. That's the thing. As for the vaccine rate in Indonesia, up till now, we have deployed, we have like 55 million doses.
Wigo discusses outbound trends from the UAE.
Maldives definitely was one of the winners throughout the year. Greece in Europe being one of the first destinations that opened for all vaccinated passengers, just a vaccine certificate, a PCR, negative PCR, and you are welcome. That sort of give it a huge push. Some other countries followed after that, so Spain, Italy, and then the rest of the European countries. But I think the notable emerging ones were Georgia, Azerbaijan, and Greece and Maldives. But now with UK, US being accessible again, I think some of the other European countries are coming into the mix. We're gonna go back, I would say, to the traditional mix that we used to see before.
Ramada JBR shares details on their source markets.
We had Russia, Kazakhstan, a few other countries from the West. UK was closed, but with the announcement of the news that we are moved to the amber zone, we've started seeing UK, Germany. We also had many other Scandinavian countries traveling and coming to us. In terms of the new markets, what we witnessed was East Europe. So Romania, Bulgaria were also markets that were quite new for us.
According to Oliver Wyman, almost 70% of global consumers plan to travel domestically within the next 6 months. Saudi Arabia to accept IATA travel pass.